Okay, when I finished our last video, we were analyzing a reflection coefficient in polar coordinates, which had a magnitude and a phase. And the phase that I just drew is 45 degrees. I did that by looking on this outside axis. Let me kind of highlight that whole axis. And let's highlight it with yellow so that you can see the axis that I'm looking at out here. Right along there is the axis that I read to be able to find the angle of the reflection coefficient. So this is the angle of the reflection coefficient. So what did you see? You saw it going from 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Up here at the top it's 90. Over here on the outside right there it's 180. We're now starting to follow it negative. It's the same thing as increasing like 270 and so on. So the angle of reflection coefficient is going to be minus 45 degrees right down here. It's going to be minus 90, which is equal to 270 over here, and so on. So let's draw a few of those angles in here. So this is 45 degrees up here at the top. Oh, let me get my pen back. This is 90 degrees. Over here is 180. Here is 270. Or minus 90 over here would be, let's see if I've got that in the right spot, 10, there's 45, minus 45 degrees. Let me kind of erase that little mark right there. So that's minus 45 degrees, and so on. So that's how we find the angle of the reflection coefficient. Now let's see how to find the magnitude of the reflection coefficient. Right down here, see how it says reflection coefficient for E or I? That's the line that I'm going to look on. Here's the center point, and the magnitude right here is 1. So if I want to be able to read that value, I can go any place from 0 to 1. Let's start out with a value of a half. So if I want to plot a reflection coefficient that has a magnitude of a half, and let's say a phase of 45 degrees. I know where the 45 degree line is, I've just drawn that, and I need to find a magnitude of a half. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring a piece of paper down here on the bottom, and I'm going to mark it, like right there and right there, so that I can see how big a half is. Then I'm going to carry my paper right up here, I'm going to mark these two points, which are marked on my paper, the magnitude right here is 0.5. I read it off this line right there. So that's the magnitude of a half and a phase of 45 degrees. Now let's find the magnitude of a half and a phase of minus 45 degrees. So here's 10, 20, 30, 40, 45. Let's draw our dashed line down using a piece of paper, as we are there, and we need to find our magnitude of a half again. So come and mark your paper right here and right there, and start at the center. Line up those marks you just made. There's a magnitude of a half, 0.5, at a phase of minus 45 degrees. So this is point A, and this is point B. So practice with that a bit. Now see if you can find something that has a magnitude of 0.7 and, let's say, a phase of 90 degrees. So let's go to 0.7. It's right there. Mark your piece of paper. Hope you're doing this on a Smith chart with me. Start at the center. We need to find our 90 degree line. Let's mark that down. And then let's start at the center again, right there. Match up my lines to where the 0.7 is. Here is a magnitude of 0.7 with a phase of 90 degrees. That is point number C.